मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड
मॉर्निंग।
मॉर्निंग। इन द टुडे क्लास, टुडे सेशन, वी विल सी अबाउट द करिकुलर रिफॉर्म इन स्कूल मैथमेटिक्स। एक्चुअली आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू डिस्कस द सेम टॉपिक इन द लास्ट क्लास, बट ड्यू टू द टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम वी कुड नॉट एबल टू कंप्लीट इट। So here we will discuss about that what are the curriculum reforms has been proposed in the school mathematics at a elementary level, at a secondary level, curriculum reforms together with the some of the reforms related to the examination. And here very specific we have to discuss about the reform at a national and state level in the light of the NCF 2005. So the NCF 2005 will be the guiding principle for us as of now. Okay, so that will be the very base of our discussion. But in the start of this class, with the start of this class, we will try to see some of the basic concept about the curriculum, that what is the curriculum, or when we see mathematics curriculum, what exactly we are meaning. So can somebody tell me that what is your conception about curriculum? What you have understood till now about the curriculum, the word when you say the curriculum, what is the curriculum in fact? Anybody?
Sir,
yes, please.
So my idea is the course of study in
course of study.
That include scholastic, post-scholastic, and examination pattern, all type of activity that performed in a particular time is curriculum.
Okay, so all type of activity that we perform in the school, even the scholastic and examination like that is the curriculum. Okay, then any other, anybody? Asutosh Panda is saying it includes both curricular and the extracurricular sector, I think. Okay, so I also respect your thinking. Anybody? Both person who replied is the Asutosh. One is the Asutosh Sahu and another one is the Asutosh Panda. And these two persons are very regularly participating in the discussion. Whatever I will ask, they will say something, whatever they know or they understand. What about the others? Vibhu?
Sir, curriculum means a systematic and organized written statement.
Achha.
in which from a subject which content is to be studied, which content should not be studied, and what activities are organized in a year and what are not ordered. For example, in the 2020 and 2021 session, there are 3 months was holiday. So
okay.
In this
it was not holiday, Vibhu. It was that we were not able to have class because of the pandemic. It's not holiday. Holiday is a different.
So the Odisha government declare not only Odisha government, they also declare the 30% syllabus should be reduced. So this is a curriculum reform.
Okay. This is the Ansuman is replying with both scholastic and non-scholastic. Achha. Anybody? One more reply I will take, then I will start talking. Lisa? Lisa Rani?
Yes,
are you here? हाँ अपनो किसी कोई भी करिकुलम ऊपरे
करिकुलम इज़ द टोटलिटी ऑफ़ एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ़ द स्टूडेंट्स
टोटलिटी ऑफ़ द एक्सपीरियंस माने कौनो माने टोटलिटी माने कौनो कौन पोजीशन द टोटलिटी माने
लेट द करिकुलम कंटेंट्स द ऑल द सब्जेक्ट एरिया एंड द कोकरिकुलर एक्टिविटीज
सो टोटलिटी मतलब आप समझ रहे हैं जो आशुतोष एंड अंशुमान वट एवर दे हैव टोल्ड ओके सो नाउ आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट बट बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द करिकुलम देयर इज अ समथिंग हैज इमर्ज्ड एंड दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज अ नेसेसिटी ऑफ पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन डिस्कशन बिकॉज व्हेन यू विल टॉक देन योर कॉन्सेप्शन कॉन्सेप्ट अबाउट द डिफरेंट थिंग बिकॉज इन ऑर्डर टू डिफाइन करिकुलम there is other concept is also needed okay so when you will tell then I will be able to understand that where is what if you will not tell then how I will know so see Ansuman has replied Asutosh has replied so based upon that I will start building the thing and even the Vibhu has replied first whatever I am seeing on the screen that Asutosh is saying that it includes both curricular and extracurricular. Ansuman is saying both scholastic and non-scholastic. See, first I will say that extracurricular or non-scholastic, this type of a nomenclature or the word is now no more valid. Because in the curricular part we were keeping the things that are prescribed that are given in the textbook like that we have a physics within the physics we are supposed to study about the motion supposed to study about the gravitation supposed to study about the other things okay so these are the curricular or scholastic part okay but other thing like that the dance like the music even the singing game and sport and participating in the literary activities speech writing essay writing this kind of activities that earlier conception was that they are the extra means they are apart from the scholastic and they are not more no more required for the holistic development of the child it is not required very much so that was the earlier conception okay but in fact when we see the recent trend and we easily can understand from the recent researches and development in the area of teaching and learning and the cognitive psychology we know that in order to excel in the scholastic area in order to excel in the curricular area it is also required that a child must participate and excel in the area that we were putting them as a extra like kind of a thing like the extra curricular suppose that a child want to excel in the studies the child must be very healthy so health from where it will come from the physical activities game and sport the child must have a mental peace from where it will come yoga music dance or doing the activity which you like it or suppose that a child want to develop the excel in the language so how it will come that part from the participation in the literary activity so the recent development and recent research says that it is not extra when we say that it is not required whenever we give a term as an extra, it means that it is not required at all, and we are taking as a granted, as a you can say that the if I will like, then I will take, but it is not a fact. And that's why now the term which we are using is the co-scholastic, co-curricular, means it is equally important as a scholastic aspect, as a curricular aspect, and both will go hand in hand. If you want to excel in the scholastic or a curricular aspect of a teaching and learning, you must take part in the dance, music, literary activity, physical activity, like that. So a scholastic and co-scholastic, we go hand to hand. Okay, is it clear?
Sure.
That so it will be my request from now onwards, you use the word like a co-curricular, co-scholastic, not a non-scholastic, not a extracurricular. It is not a extra. Suppose that I will give you this watch, and I will give you, so you take this watch, and this is extra with this. Yes, without this also it can work. But it is, but when I will talk about that, the watch plus the battery, so both are complementary to each other. Battery will alone, the battery doesn't have any meaning, because alone battery, what you will do? And alone watch without the battery, what you will do? You won't do anything. Can you do anything? No, you can't do anything. Or the pen without the refill, you can't use the pen. Or the pen with the refill without this outer cover, it is difficult to use. Okay, so both are complementary to each other, and both are required. Suppose that when I will talk about the pen and a refill, both are required. Alone refill won't work, alone this cover won't work. So both are required. Okay, so in the teaching learning also, both are required, because for study, the healthy mind is required, healthy body is required. Okay, so this is that. The another thing I will like to highlight here, that due to the pandemic, whatever the government has decided for the school to reduce the syllabus, it is the reduction in the syllabus. It is not reduction in the curriculum. Curriculum is the same. It is a reduction in the syllabus. Syllabus means, syllabus is the, suppose that this is your syllabus. I am opening your syllabus to what to teach. So here in the pedagogy of mathematics, there is a 5 unit, and within the 5 unit, something is given, that what you are supposed to study within that units. So that content reduction is done. Because of the pandemic, school are not operating physically, and there is a hurdle, there is a limitation in organizing the teaching learning activity in the online mode. Even several times we also face the problem. So it is a reduction in a content, syllabus, not in a curriculum. The second point, you cannot say it as a curriculum reform, because there is no reform. Reform, when we will see that curriculum reform or a reform in anything, it will be based upon some research evidence, that this type of a curriculum we are having, how it is impacting, and what is necessary to do. What is the necessity, and what is the research evidence? Like that, the government has also decided earlier, not due to this pandemic, that to reduce the work load, means the content load, reduction of the content load, and more emphasis towards the conceptual learning. So the content load will be more, less, so there will be more emphasis on the understanding of the concept. Even earlier this type of a thing happened, that when we will start discussing about the curriculum reform in this discussion. Then we will see like that when you will see the textbook before NCF 2005 and the textbook after NCF 2005, like that the textbook now we are using, you will find there is a huge shift in the content load and the transaction modality. Okay, so these are the curricular reform. Okay, this that we are using, it is a not a reform, it is a just a immediate action taken to suit the situation, because the situation is that a student and a teacher are not able to come to the class and they are not able to meet physically to have the class. So that was the hurdle, and for that hurdle this type of a decision we have taken. So that is that. Is it clear this two three things?
Yes, sir.
Hello. So now we will come to the curriculum. What is the curriculum? One right response I have got, that is the curriculum is the totality of experience. Okay, totality of experience. But she was not able to define properly what that totality of experience, because when we see say the totality of experience means it means something. What is the meaning of the totality of experience? Totality of experience is not that scholastic and co-scholastic only. Of course it is a part of that, but it is not only scholastic and co-scholastic, curricular and co-curricular. There is more than that, and for that you have to see the here we will see a brief historical overview of the curriculum development, and we will see also that how we learn, that is the theory of learning. So there was a earlier conception when the term curriculum was coined. So there was a earlier conception, and in fact the term like a curriculum was not coined till 1950s. It was not there. And if we talk about the present situation, even it is still emerging, still coming out, the concept of curriculum, that what is the concept, how should it should be defined. So earlier conception was that whatever the teaching learning happening inside the classroom, that is only required for the holistic development of the child, and that was only supposed as a curriculum. That was only supposed because they have thought that this is the only required thing. So this is the curriculum, but we know that that is not only required even, and that was not sufficient even for the holistic development of the child. And from the learning, teaching learning process, the cognitive psychology, we came to know that the learning is not a kind of a thing which happens only inside the classroom. It happens outside the classroom also. It happens inside the premises of a school also. It happens outside the school premises also. And in fact, it happens everywhere. When we are talking with the friends, when we are talking with the parents, when we are talking with the community member, when we are interacting with anything, even the non-living thing, we used to learn. And so, for the holistic development, holistic learning, the all thing that imparts learning, that inculcates something, is a cause for the learning of the child. And that's why when we try to define a curriculum, we say the totality of experience. And that totality means the activities happening inside the classroom, the activities happening outside the classroom even, the activities happening inside the four wall of the boundary wall of the school, and the activities happening outside the four wall of the school, the activities happening inside the family means the house, the activities happening outside the house. And that's why when we talk about the curriculum, all those things are meticulously defined and planned. And that's why when we give the homework or the any group work or a collaborative work, we say them, observe these things and make a report what you have observed, so that the it should be a planned kind of activity to observe something and on to reflect on the observation, what you have observed and what you have learned out of the observation. So when we talk about the curriculum, it is a totality of experience, means all the experience is a part of a curriculum. And that's why the role of a teacher is a very challenging here, because you have to plan the activity the child will do inside the classroom, outside the classroom, inside the school premises, outside the school premises, in the society, in the house, outside the house, when they are talking, everything. So the totality is meant in that way. Okay, is this clear? Up to here, is this clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Huh. So that is that. Etymologically, when we talk about the curriculum, it is available everywhere. So just I will read out, and then I think you will be understand. So it is a etymologically it is a derived from the Latin word which means the race course, or the word race course is a suggestive of the course, the path, hai na, the time, the fixed time or the path that must be covered in the fixed time. It's a path. It is that should be covered in the fixed way. Earlier, as I was giving you the historically overview, that earlier the concept of curriculum was that it is the things which is happening inside the classroom or the teacher is saying. Later on, they have thought no, outside is also. So again, they have broadened the definition of a curriculum, and finally they have find out that the learning can happen everywhere. So they have again broadened the definition. Earlier it was meant only to a syllabus only. We will see that what is the syllabus, what is the curriculum framework, what is the curriculum that we have seen. We will define all those things also. And in the 1962, the Hilda Taba, they are the two person, the Hilda Taba, who are very prominent researchers in the area of a curriculum. So the name of a Taba and a Hilda you will find everywhere when you will go for the study of the curriculum. In the 1962, they have defined curriculum as a plan for learning. That what is the plan, that plan for learning. And in the 1973, the Good has defined curriculum as a general overall plan of the content or a specific material of instruction that a school should offer the student by the qualifying him a certification. Means the for the certification, whatever the things we are doing. But in the 1987 MacDonald, and in the 1987 the Portley has pointed out that the curriculum should comprised of the learning experience, not a mere plan. So it should not be a mere plan, but it should be focused and based upon the learning experience, and from there the totality of experience word emerged and that conception came. And in the 1980s, the Portley has defined that the curriculum is a plan or a outline. First thing means these are the component will be there. It must have a plan and the outline. It must include the instructional material to be used by the learner and a teacher as a tech. Suppose that, for example, as a teacher, for example, that is the textbook, workbook, guidebook, supporting material, teaching aid, like that. It must also include the teaching learning activities to be carried out. Okay, and it must be based upon the previous learning of the student. Okay, so these should be the part of the curriculum. It should also have a scheme of evaluation that and the suggested procedure or a tool for evaluation, means how you will evaluate, what kind of a tool, what kind of which kind of a set of a question or anything, or there will be observation, there will be a activity, how you will evaluate those learning. Okay, when we see that the conception of a curriculum in the Indian culture, it has come from the Pathyakram. Okay, and the literary meaning of the Pathyakram is a Vidya. Okay, so Vidya in the Indian culture is the highest level of a learning. Okay, Sikhna, like that, na, knowledge, knowing is a Sikhna. So the Vidya is the highest level of a learning. So when we talk about the curriculum, it is meant that through the curriculum designed, all kind of a learning experience the child will be given, and as a output, as a outcome, they will achieve the highest level of learning. Okay. Is there any doubt or any question up to here?
No, sir.
बताऊंगा मैं तो बोला अभी आप नहीं सुन रहे थे सुन रहे थे ना तो आपको कैसा मिस कर गया सो एक्चुअली माई strategy of teaching in online mode is that one chunk I will discuss, then I used to have a question answer session. Means I am asking you that if you have any doubt or a question, you may ask. Then again one chunk I am teaching, and then I am asking for the question. So like that I used to teach in the online mode. So one chunk I have completed, that is a conception about the curriculum. I have asked you for the question, and then I will go towards the other, hai na? So I have thought of discussing because, but you have asked also, so let me finish that part now only. So now there is a 3-4 term, like that. One term is the syllabus, one term is a curriculum, one term is a curriculum framework. So we will start from the highest hierarchy, that is the curriculum framework. When we talk about the curriculum framework, it is a document that suggests the vision of the teaching learning process that will be imparted. Means through the teaching learning, what kind of a thing you want to achieve and how it will be achieved. what you want to achieve and how it will be achieved. And before framing this vision, there is a research evidence. Obviously, when we will talking about the in the academia, everything will be based upon the research evidences. Without the research evidences, there will be nothing. So curriculum framework is the highest highest hierarchy. It is a framework that suggests that what should be the vision, why we should teach that, why we should incorporate that, and how it will be done. Like that, when I hope that you must have seen the national curriculum framework. How many of you have seen that national curriculum framework? Only you have. And what about others?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
From the very first day of your class, when you have taken admission, since then I am telling you that you must go through that, at least once you see that. So those who have seen the document, now they may be able to link my word to the document. You will find that there is a different section in the document. Section related to the assessment, evaluation, pedagogy. Even within the pedagogy, there is a different section for a different subject. And they suggest a vision that what they want to achieve out of the school education. What they want to achieve and how it will be achieved. In between, they also used to say that what is the hurdle, what is the challenge. So challenge is the rational. Challenge is not very important point of discussion here. Challenge is the rational, because whenever they will put a vision or whenever they will suggest, they will come up with the something, they must come with a rational, that why they are suggesting that. Okay, so rational part is a different, but mainly when we talk about the curriculum framework, it suggests a vision, mission, what they want to achieve and how it will be achieved, how it will be evaluated. So that is a curriculum. But when we talk about the curriculum, that is the curriculum framework. But when we talk about the curriculum only, so the curriculum is a detailed outline or a scheme to achieve the vision that is emphasized in the curriculum framework. So like that, when we talk about the mathematics, the vision of NCF 2005, that is the curriculum framework at a school level that we have now, says that mathematics education should be the mathematization. Means by the mathematics learning, the child must be able to be precise in their work, be accurate, must able to have a scientific procedures, problem solving ability, and so on. How it will be achieved, that will be a part of curriculum. Means in order to achieve that, you must learn the algebra, trigonometry, geometry, arithmetic, and that's why I used to say that the content is a tool or is a vehicle to inculcate the nature of the discipline within the child. Nature of the discipline, what is the nature of the mathematics is? It is a precise, it is a accurate, it is a symbolic, like that. It is abstract. So that thing needs to be inculcated. That will contribute towards the mathematization. And these are the tools. Content is a vehicle. So that will be a part of a curriculum. But that won't be only alone the part of a curriculum. in order to learn those things, you must be very healthy. So the health and the physical education part will be there. You must be very accurate and precise. So related to some activity will be there. Evaluation will be also there, so that these things would be evaluated. So evaluation will be based upon what? Lower level thinking or higher order processing skills. So there will be scheme of evaluation. When you will see the curriculum, see it is a not a, it is a syllabus that you have a, it is a syllabus. ठीक है, that's why it doesn't have a, all the things. But when you will see the curriculum, I will show you the curriculum also sometime. So when you will see the curriculum, you will find that there is a section on how to evaluate. There is a section on what kind of activities they should have. There is a section about how to do the curriculum transaction. Transactional instruction will be also there. Objective will be also there. As a, like that, everything will be there. That is the curriculum. For example, you can download the curriculum for 9 and 10 class from the CBSE website. You will find all the things is incorporated there. But when we talk about the syllabus only, so syllabus is a list of content only that needs to be learned within a course of study. Suppose that the, I am talking about the mathematics of class 9. So in the mathematics of class 9, what are the things we are supposed to study, that it will be listed. So that is the syllabus. Is it clear, Asutosh?
Yes, sir. Very clear. Yes, sir.
Very clear. Very clear. So, okay. Thank you for confirming me.
Thank you, sir.
So now we will have a discussion on the recent trend in curriculum development. First we will see the recent trend in the curriculum development, and from there at last we will come to the recent trend in the mathematics curriculum specifically. So here we will see that what are the trend in the curriculum development. And specifically our focus will be on the mathematics obviously. So as I think you must be well known that there is a shift in preparation of a curriculum, and the shift is from the behaviorism to constructivism. There is a approach, behavioristic approach of teaching and learning. And there is a shift from that to a constructivist approach of teaching and learning. And the constructivist approach, it is not like that, it is a very new thing. There are lots of researches happen in that, even the Vygotsky and all those things they have researched long back before. But particularly in India, when we talk the National Curriculum Framework, that is the NCF 2005, that advocates the paradigm shift from the behaviorism to constructivism. Okay, so can somebody tell me that what is the behaviorism and what is the constructivism?
Sir, behaviorism is the it can it can just from any
okay, Asutosh, your voice is not audible to me. Can you type in the chat?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Please. And the one more thing, am I teaching to only Asutosh? Because all the time Asutosh is only replying and you people are sitting silently. if you have a difficulty like that, the network difficulty, you can type in the chat box also. Asutosh used to reply, both Asutosh, Sahu and Panda. Then sometime Ansuman also reply, sometime Kavita also reply. But what about the other? Viswaranjan also replies sometimes. Ayushmati, she is not replying anytime. And even Ayushmati, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Achha. So what about you? Why you are not replying anything? What you are no, why you are not saying anything? Subhasri Maharana, are you here? Subhasri?
Yes, sir.
So why you are silent? Banaji Mishra, you have replied, sir. What is the sir? Matlab, you are here, you are telling me. Soumya Raj Sinha? Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Haan, so how I will know that you are here? Whenever I am asking some question, you should reply, then I will know that you are here. Okay. Okay, so Ansuman, I am waiting your message. Sorry, Ansuman, Asutosh. Asis is applying too much noise here. Matlab kya hai, Ansuman?
Sir, actually,
too much noise
hai. Sir, actually, main abhi chhat ke upar ghar mein tha, to bachche log chilla rahe
the. Acha, type kar do baba, type kar do na kuch. लास्ट टाइम तो आपने टाइप किया इंक्लूड बोथ स्कोलास्टिक एंड नॉन स्कोलास्टिक, टाइप किया ना, टाइप कर दो. आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू आर फेसिंग डिफिकल्टी, लेकिन कोई भी रिप्लाई नहीं करते हैं ना. सो हाउ आई विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट एवरीबडी इज फेसिंग डिफिकल्टी? इफ एवरीबडी इज फेसिंग डिफिकल्टी, देन देयर इज नो मतलब पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग ऑनलाइन क्लास रियली. You can tell me also. I will think of something other if everybody is facing difficulty. Okay, let it be. So Asis is replying, behaviorism is a systematic approach to understanding the behavior of a human and other animal. Okay. बंद कर दिया, ठीक है. Constructivism, problem solving. Okay, behaviorism is based on a learning by following the attitude or a behavior of a teacher or by following the task given to a student. Asutosh is saying it is a permanent change in the behavior of a human or an animal. When we give some condition, stimulus, yes. Constructivists say that people construct the thought or to gain the knowledge due to the Asutosh. In particular, environmental setup, behaviorism say that the behavior is a key structure of learning. Now, something is a correct, that is a reply by the Viswaranjan to some extent. Asutosh and Banaja Mishra also, but it is not more than 10% correctness. Very crude reply it is that. Very raw reply. I think, have you heard of these two terms earlier? Kabhi aapne padha hai? Kisi ne, I think so many times I have taught you. Ansuman is saying me also the behavioral psychology, the learning based upon the idea that the behavior is part of the conditioning. Yes, you are right, Ansuman. But it is also not correct, very much correct. Okay, so आपको किसी ने बताया है बिहेवियरिज्म और कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म के बारे में कभी?
यस सर, यस सर.
In which paper you have been taught about these two terms?
P3 teaching only behaviorism problems killer and teaching
migrant teaching. So, yes, you are very much right. But why you are not able to define, suppose that this will be asked in the exam. You are not able to define. Okay. So, I think for the today time is over, so you have to also join our next class. I will start the next class with the brief discussion on the constructivism and the behaviorism. Okay, so brief discussion I will have and then I will talk. Okay, so we will stop this session here only. Okay, shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, thank you for being with me. Have
thank
a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.